Kara, did it seem kind of appropriate that this game would go to overtime again with how this rivalry has gone recently?
Yeah, I mean, we knew coming in that they were a really good team, so needing some extra time on the clock to really determine the end of the game is kind of seems like a fitting end.
What happened on the last play in overtime? It sounded like Dawn was yelling for a timeout. Did you kind of change your mind to just go ahead and go and try to find the shot? What was kind of going on in the last sequence?
No, I didn't know that we had a timeout left, and she had told us that if they missed the free throw, we would call it, and if not, we were just going to go.
Chloe, how did you feel like, obviously had an 11-point lead at halftime. What changed in the second half to where they were able to come back?
Right, you know, we knew going into halftime that they were going to come back and try to push really hard in the third quarter. You know, we tried to counter that as best we could. But, I mean, two really good teams going at it today. That's all I really got to say, I guess.
Kara, defensively, it seemed like you guys really did a good job of clogging things up in the middle, a lot of double teams. What was kind of the game plan on defense?
I mean, we know that they have some really good explosive drivers. So it was kind of our standard man principles. Our rotation was pretty good. I think down the stretch we gave up, you know, some fouls and stuff in there, but for the most part we did a pretty good job.
Chloe, I know you just lost the game, but this rivalry, how it's gone, how good these two teams are this year, has that been fun to be a part of with how these games have gone and how good both teams are?
I don't think you guys would believe me if I said no. You know, I mean, this atmosphere, both at Frost and at the Skuska, that's something that not a lot of leagues have. So that's a pretty special thing to be a part of. And I know our entire team, we take advantage of that. You know, we're kind of taking that in. It's a fun environment. We like it when it goes our way, of course. But two good teams today. It's fun.
You guys got 22 more shot attempts than State today. Does that make this a little bit tougher to swallow that you're able to, you know, kind of beat them up like that?
I don't think so. I think it more speaks to the fact that we were crashing the old boards and really trying to finish plays and working our butts off. We wanted this one. So the fact that we got more shots, I think, kind of just speaks to how hard we worked.
Is it tougher to take the loss in overtime than it would have happened in regulation? Does that affect how it feels after the game at all?
A loss is a loss.
Yeah.
I mean, whether it's, if it takes 3 hours, if it takes 2 days, if you lose, you lose. Or if you win, you win, so.
Kara, is it safe to say that you think these are two teams that both belong in the NCAA tournament, regardless of what happens in the conference balls?
I mean, I might be a little biased, but I would say, you know, we've played some pretty good teams this year. We've played some ranked teams, as has South Dakota State, and I think we've kind of shown that we deserve to be in that top tier teams that make the tournament.
Does a loss like this make you that much more, I mean, everyone kind of expects it, that there's going to be a round three here?
We still have two games left in the conference season, so I think we're kind of looking just to our next opponent right now.